In this lesson, we will explore the role of food within the Sustainable Development Framework, and we will understand how food is a transversal topic for the Agenda 2030, covering most, if not even all, the SDGs. Yes, when I say food, I mean the food we eat every day, our daily fuel. But what is food for us? Every day, we see food on our tables, at the restaurants, and in the supermarkets. But food is much more than this. Food, or better, food systems, consist of both all the elements, such as environment, people, inputs, processes, infrastructures, institutions, and activities that relate to the production, processes, distribution, preparation, and consumption of food. But also, food systems include the outcomes of these activities, namely nutrition, health status, socioeconomic growth, and equity. Food systems, indeed, usually start with agriculture and farmers and their interaction with natural resources and environment. Then we find food in food industry and transportation. And then food arrives to retailers and sellers, like supermarkets. And finally, on our tables. After that, often it becomes waste, food waste. And it can return back to nature, for instance, as fertilizer or compost. So, food systems are characterized by complex supply chain, constituted by several activities, covering global distances, contributed to natural resource consumption, and involving several actors, from farmers to policymakers to citizens, each citizen. But nowadays, is our food system sustainable? First of all, what are sustainable food systems? The high-level panel of experts on food security and nutrition of the United Nations defines sustainable food systems as food systems that ensure food security and nutrition for all, in such a way that the economic, social, environmental basis to generate food security and nutrition of future generations are not compromised. So, going back to our first question, is our current food system sustainable? Under a global perspective, the trends in the sustainability of food systems can be summarized into four main points or paradoxes. First, the simultaneous presence of under- and overnutrition. Second, the environmental impact of food production. Third, the issue of food loss and waste. And fourth, the socioeconomic role of food. I will now go deeper into each of these four points, and I will try to present them under the lens of SDGs. First, let's start from us. Food consumers. Food is our daily fuel, and we need enough, good and healthy fuel every day. But under a global perspective, we face several and opposite nutritional challenges and forms of malnutrition, since undernutrition coexists with overnutrition. According to the FAO annual report on state of food insecurity, in 2017, 821 million people were undernourished, meaning those facing chronic food deprivation. And these numbers has increased from around 804 million with respect to 2016, with an increase of about 2% in 1 year. On the other hand, due to the adoption of unhealthy diets and lifestyles, more than 2 billion people are overweight or obese, and alarming increases are occurring among children. According to the WHO, the World Health Organization, only in Italy, more than 30% of children and teenagers between 5 and 19 is overweight. The second important dimension in the food system is the environmental one. From agriculture until consumption, food is affecting the environment. The production of food is among the measures responsible for water consumption, since between 60 and 85% of national water withdrawals are due to the only agriculture. Then we have climate change, with agriculture and food production contributing to a great fraction of global greenhouse gas emissions. Then we have fish stock, exploitation, deforestation, and other pollutant emissions linked to the energy use, transportation, industrial processes, and food storage. On the other hand, these environmental impacts cause a direct negative feedback on the agriculture, which is among the most affected sectors by climate change and natural resource scarcity. As a third point, linked to the previous one, the issue of food loss and waste is crucial in food sustainability. According to the FAO, 1/3 of the food we produce is wasted every year. These losses occur both in pre-consumption phases, due for example to weak infrastructures in storage facility, but also due to consumers who produce food waste, often due to the lack of awareness on food issues. Given the significant use of resources needed to produce food, food loss and waste mean waste of resources. Finally, as a fourth point, food plays an important role within our economy, society, and our cultures. Within current food systems, family farming constitutes 95% of farming activities. When these families sell their products, they interact with agribusiness with economies of scale and strong market power, since they are often monopolies. These mechanisms cause income inequalities and contribute to rural poverty. Beside income, gender equality characterizes current food systems. Women are said to produce between 60 and 80% of global food, but they have on average lower income and fewer rights over the land they tend with respect to men. Additionally, to conclude, all the food aspects mentioned in the three first points affect our economy, from the consumption of resources to the health expenses due to nutrition-related diseases. For example, in the only European 28, these costs amount to 700 billion euros every year. Given the above described issue, food transition has been identified as one of the six transitions necessary towards Agenda 2030. For this reason, we have to act now. But what can we do? Here, three major points. Given the global dimension of food system and the fact that food-related issues do not have borders, we need cooperation, collaboration, and sharing of best practices. Second, the multifaceted nature of food sustainability calls for systemic and multidisciplinary approaches, from research to policymaking. And the SDGs provide an effective framework to pursue these approaches. Finally, the participation of all of us in our daily choices is crucial. As shown by the double pyramid published by the Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition Foundation, food that is good for our health is likely to be good also for our environment. Summarizing, in this lesson, we have seen that food sustainability issues and solutions touch all the SDGs. Therefore, food is a transversal topic within sustainability.